Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial I will show you how you can create trigger links inside ActiveCampaign. And those are really cool to, for example, segment your audience or to let people create like their own funnel experience, basically. So let's dive right in, then I will explain you what it is, what you can use them for, and then I'm also going to show you a bunch of cool examples. So first of all, what are trigger links? So it's not like a special link, it's just like a regular link, like a unique link that we add to our emails. And then we ask people to click one of those links. And then when they do that, something will happen. So the link triggers an action. So that's why I call it a trigger link. I have no clue if it's an official term, but I just like to use the word trigger links. Now, what can you use them for? I basically already said it a bit. So I think they're really cool to like segment your audience, but also to continue an automation so that you can let people create their own experience. So I want to show you three cool examples that I'm using in my own business. So the first one is about segmentation. So I want to know what email service provider people are using. The next one is about letting people decide if they want to have the next email lesson right now or tomorrow. And the last one is about how you can like exit an automation if someone clicks a link telling you that they're not interested in it. So the first one is about which email service provider someone is using. So you obviously probably have different segments, but for me, it's relevant to know what ESP someone is using so that I can send emails based on that. So let me show you what this email looks like. And then you can also see those trigger links inside this email. So as you can see, it's just like a regular email. So it says something like, "Hey Max, quick question. I'm working on some new content and it would help me a lot to know which email service provider you are using. Just click one of the links below to let me know." And then you see a bunch of different links. And all these links go to the same page. So you do not have to create like 100 different pages for this. So this is the page that I'm using for my segmentation. So as soon as someone clicks one of these links, they go to this page that says, "Thanks for letting me know. This will help me to make my emails more relevant." Now, but the thing is that to make this work, every link has to be unique. But it's really easy to do that. So I will edit this and then you can see what I did there. So you see here that I have my website, maxvankollenburg.com/trigger/thanks. This is that page, right? Here you can see that here. And then you have to add like a query string like this. So you have to add ? And then I say ESP is ActiveCampaign. And really what you add here, it does not matter. You can also add here AC or 1 or G or just something random as long as the link is unique. So this will help to do that. So I just like to make it some kind of like organized. So I just say ESP is ActiveCampaign. And then this query string makes the link unique. So you see here with MailChimp, they go to that same page, the thanks page, and then we add ? ESP is MailChimp. But again, this could also just say 2, then the link is also unique, but I just like this so that it's easy further on in the automation to recognize which link someone clicked. Now you also see here, ConvertKit, and it says ESP is ConvertKit, and then something else just says ESP is other. And then when we go back to our automation, you will see that we're first going to wait until someone clicked any link inside that email. So we send the email and then we say, "Wait until has clicked any link in campaign, which ESP do you use?" So we send it, someone will wait here until they click a link in this. And then after they do that, they will continue. And then they go in an if else, and if else, if else, if else, to basically check which trigger link they clicked. And this is the whole magic basically. So here you see, does the contact match the following conditions? Has clicked on a link, and then you have to select the email. So the email's called which ESP do you use? And then the link that they click is ESP is ActiveCampaign. So this is why I would recommend to give them like clear names. But you see also in this list, all the different trigger links that we have here, Infusionsoft, Drip, ConvertKit, MailChimp. It's like pretty easy, right? So if yes, if that person clicked that link, then they follow the yes path, and then I set an email, or then I set a custom field called email service provider to ActiveCampaign. So this is like a custom field I created to store my segments. So then you see here, if not, then we check, okay, did this person then click the link with MailChimp in it? If yes, we set email service provider to MailChimp. If not, we check, now was it ConvertKit? Then we set it to ConvertKit. Now, and so on, we just check which link this person basically clicked. Pretty cool, right? So that's just because every link is unique, even though they're still going all to this same page. Now, the next example that I want to show you is for a free email course. So this email course is really cool because people can follow it on their own pace. So sometimes you see, or most often, that email courses will send out a lesson every day. And I was like, yeah, but if people are like really engaged with our content, why would we not just send the next lesson right away if they want to? So you see here, for example, we have a welcome email. And inside that welcome email, we're going to ask people to click a trigger link to let us know when they want the next lesson. Now, so you see here that we just have the email, just like a standard email. And then you see here that we have a link that says next lesson now, next lesson tomorrow. So the URL for now looks like this. It says trigger now. The page looks like this. It says, cool, next lesson is on its way. The next lesson will be in your inbox in about 10 minutes because I know that ActiveCampaign needs some time to like process a link click. So it's not like instant, but that's pretty cool. And the tomorrow link looks like this. It just says trigger tomorrow and that page looks like this. So I created these different pages, and those are basically all the pages that I have, plus one more that I will show you in a bit. So this one I use for all my segmentation stuff. This one I use to let people know like, hey, cool, I will send you the next lesson tomorrow. And this one is for, hey, the next lesson will be in your inbox in about 10 minutes. And then inside our automation, if we go back to that, then we can continue when they click that now link. So basically, when they click the tomorrow link, we don't do anything with it. Then they just wait until it's midnight, and then we wait until it's 10 in the morning, and then we send our next lesson. But with this goal, you see here, once lesson one now, we check if they clicked a trigger link inside the welcome email. So here it says, has clicked on a link, welcome. And then you see here that says trigger now. So if they click that now link inside the welcome email, then they will jump here automatically and then they get lesson one. And then in lesson one, I can show you real quick, we basically do the same thing again. So also in that email lesson, there is now, imagine here is a lesson and then the ask, in the end, we just ask them like, hey, just let me know, do you want to receive the next lesson right now or tomorrow? And then you see that we have a now link and a tomorrow link. And then when we go back to the automation, you'll see that we basically do the same trick again and again and again. So here you see that we have a goal that where we check has clicked on a link in lesson one, and the link is the now link, and then the person will jump there and receive lesson two. Pretty cool, right? Like this way you can really like, yeah, make people make their own experience. So if you want to know more about this email course, then I also created a separate tutorial about that. Be sure to watch that if you want to know more. Now then, the last example that I want to show you is about a promotion that you maybe have. And yeah, it would be really shit if people are going to unsubscribe from your promotion while they're still kind of interested in your content, right? So I'm, for example, doing like a weekly newsletter, and then sometimes I do like a little promotion because yeah, I also have to earn some money, right? And then I do not want people to unsubscribe from my list if they're like, oh, I'm not interested in this promotion. I want to give them an option to opt out from the promotion, but not from my main list, basically. So to do that, I created a trigger link that people can click if they're not interested in the promotion. So let me show you what that looks like. So here we have our email. Now, very standard email, nothing in it. But then in the end of the email, that's what it is all about. We have like our unsubscribe link that says, hey, want completely off the list. No problem, just click here. And that's just like your regular unsubscribe link. And then it is about this. This is like a link with a trigger link or a row. So it says, not interested in this, just click here and I won't bother you about it anymore. So this link, let me edit it and then you can see it, is maxcolumber.com/trigger/not interested. When they click this link, they go to this page. It says, ok, no problemo, I won't bother you about this anymore. A little sad photo of me and then a button that takes them to the blog if they want. So that's also pretty cool, right? So when they click this in any of my promotion emails, so this automation consists of, I don't know how many emails, but like here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 emails. And all these emails have that not interested link in them. So then here in the end of the automation, you see that we have a goal that says not interested. And inside this goal, we check if someone clicked on that not interested trigger link in any of the emails. So here you see all the different emails. And then you can see here, it says trigger not interested, trigger not interested, and so on and so on. So when someone is clicking that not interested link in any of these emails, boom, they will just jump to the end of the automation and then they exit the automation so that they do not get unsubscribed from my list, but they don't get bothered about this promotion anymore. I think that's also like a really cool tactic. So that was this about trigger links. The next tutorial is also going to be extremely cool, I think. It is about ActiveCampaign conditional content. So how you can personalize your emails based on tags and custom fields a subscriber has. So if you want to be crazy personal inside your emails, then be sure to watch that tutorial. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, give it a little thumbs up. And if you want to see more tutorials like this, then be sure to subscribe.